This project has been something that in our organization, just a quick recap, we have 32 John Deere dealerships, farm equipment dealerships across 5 states, and we have about 1,000 employees, 500 of them being technicians, repair the equipment and so forth. We bill out at $160 an hour, which is about $2.66 a minute. So we have opportunity. We can call it low-hanging fruit, but quite frankly, we have fruit that's on the ground rotting. And that's our pain point. We're leaving money on the table, so to speak, at the tune of about $1 million per month. And so that calculates out from 85% is where we're currently at. We want to start moving it to 100%. So even for every point move, it's a huge dollar amount. So it's something that really we haven't put focus on. Believe it or not, we've been very fragmented. And I spent time in the field for, you know, the last 20 years. And I wish I'd have had this tool then, because we would have really formalized what we really need to do to capture this. Our learning personas really involve probably more than this when we break it down like Rosella did. But essentially, we start with our technician students. We have about 100 students in 2-year associate degree diesel programs. And so we want to get them up to speed quicker while they're in school. And I'm going to work with the colleges to do that, to drip this on them when they're in class, but then they come out and they actually work for 9 weeks in the field, four different times, throughout those 2 years. So there's a lot of opportunity for hands-on learning there. We have what I call bronze technicians, and they're the 1 to 3 years that they've started their career full-time. They're getting used to a lot of new things, but yet they struggle with diagnostics and troubleshooting, and that's where we lose time. We write the time off, and then they lose confidence, and then essentially we potentially lose them. The silver gold are kind of our senior skilled technicians, some of them very skilled, but there's a lot of opportunity here. We still have people writing time off. And so we have to work with getting a lot of those people recalibrated. All of these technicians are paid monthly. They have a performance incentive tied directly to this. So they do have a huge opportunity and an incentive to improve. Service administrators help set up the jobs. We have work orders. The language has to be clear to the customer. So that's the role of the service administrator. Depending on our location, they have the responsibility really to almost be the assistant to the service manager. And sometimes they're dealing directly with the technicians and giving them direct feedback and coaching. So they're a big piece of this puzzle. And then finally, the service managers, which really have control over the whole job in some cases. We like to use job pricing for everything. So then the customer knows what the price is going to be before they even, you know, leave the dealership. These are the personas. And really, the service manager can just write the time off without even talking to the technician. What we hope to achieve here is better communication. So if there's the gaps where I see that we need to work in all areas, starting with service managers, service administrators, is the setting the expectations, so the communication with the techs, making sure they have the assignment figured out, and then so organizational skills, and then for the technicians, diagnostic and troubleshooting, technical writing. So there's a lot to be learned in that area as well. Some of the assets I found that we do have, but we've got a lot that need to be put together in our immediate. You know, service advisor is the diagnostic tool. So we would focus in on that. A lot of these things blend to all these personas. And I think the mentoring and the peer-to-peer will be a big piece. We're going to use like Signal and Microsoft Teams. I didn't get that on here because I want to make sure that we can use that. And then we've got some formal classes that we can provide. To track this, it's going to be quite easy to track because we know where we've been averaging and we can we can see it in all of our monthly reports, our weekly reports on the progress, and then ultimately the dollars as we go through each month. So that's a big flyover. It's a huge project, but you can see it'll be well worth the time spent.